Well, for a closer look at virtual tourism, I spoke with John Graham. He's the president of Travel World VR, a company specializing in virtual reality for travel marketing to promote destinations. And I began by asking him how his company's focus has changed since the onset of the coronavirus pandemic.
When we started 2.5 years ago, we launched the company as more of a production VR company. And with my partner, Steve Perillo, many people remember his father with his iconic TV ads back in 1980, pioneering TV advertising. So we're doing the same thing with this new medium, which is becoming more mainstream every day. So being unable to do productions, we launched our app actually a year ago, Travel World VR, and we're taking pre-existing content from people that already have 360 video, and we're placing it on our app for free as a goodwill gesture with what's going on in the world. And our audience is travel agents, meeting and incentive planners, as well as their clients, which are the consumer.
Right.
So it's allowing them to continue to engage with the travel shutdown.
So let's chat a bit about what experiences a lot of these armchair travelers actually prefer. Is it more of a VR experience where they can sort of sit back and relax and just sort of be immersed in the experience, or something more interactive where perhaps they get to tour a museum or stop and look at particular works of art?
Most people will view it at home, get an immersive experience, and be better educated on where they're going to go once they can go. But we have been getting a lot of calls from museums. We got a call from Machu Picchu. We have a proposal into them, because a lot of these historic sites don't really want a lot of tourists in certain areas where it's decaying or whatever, so they can have a VR experience.
We've certainly seen places like the Faroe Islands, that is the case, and they really had a hit with their interactive walking tour, where a virtual visitor with a remote console can control where the guide goes and can even make them run or jump. Can you give us other examples of some of these clever and successful remote tourism campaigns?
Yeah, we have a few on our app. We have a London walking tour and different areas where, you know, it's too remote to actually go to certain parts, but there's other parts that you can go to. So it's an educational experience, which is going to really make you want to go more once the travel ban is lifted. So people like Italy who have done it with us, Jamaica, the cruise lines, they're going to have one step up on their competitors who don't have this new mainstream technology.
Now, we know that being immersed in the sights and sounds is one thing, but what about the other senses that we tend to use when we travel in person? We know that there's already 5D special effect movie theaters that incorporate things like rain or perhaps even air blowing on you. Is there a way to make VR at home feel more real for visitors?
Yeah, there is, and the technology is changing every day, and we have the best production company in the business based in the UK, Infinite MR, who have been doing this for over 8 years. So that's augmented reality in combination with virtual reality, which is now mixed reality. So that's the new buzzword. So the technology is changing every day, but the great thing about it is it's becoming more mainstream. You can view it on our app, either on a mobile experience, just on a 360, or you could actually, we provide free headsets to everybody that downloads our Travel World VR app. So if you go on our app, travelworldvr.com, on your phone, and we'll send you a free headset where you can have a true VR immersive experience.
And just quickly, because you did mention education for things like field trips, obviously a lot of those canceled. How do you see VR tours and lessons filling that gap now, and when perhaps all the coronavirus restrictions are lifted? Could you lose all that market share?
No, I think it's just going to enhance it. You know, we've been getting a lot of calls from museums, from colleges who can't have commencement celebrations to do it in a VR experience. But eventually, you know, once you're able to go, you know, you can combine both of them. People that aren't able to go to a university commencement experience in, say, New York, if you live in South Africa, you know, it's just going to enhance the experience.